Hi there, it's good to have you back with us for more Explore Tulsa. On the new Netflix special from Jerry Seinfeld, Jerry tells us that florists should name their arrangements by what kind of trouble the guy is into.
Oh, now that's a great idea. So for you, you'd probably spend a lot of money on the "you're such a child" arrangement.
Whatever. All I know is Nikki and Galen know exactly what I need every time I get in trouble with the wife.
The big plan was I wanted to go to law school and I wanted to go into politics, but ended up staying in the floral business. Probably at a young age, because I think all little girls, you know, are decorating and playing with flowers and doing their Barbies and all that kind of stuff. So I knew that I already enjoyed doing those kinds of things.
I couldn't help but work with my mom. She opened her first shop in 1963 when I was just a kiddo. And I would love to go by the shop after school and hang out and watch the designers and play in the flowers. They let me make any bouquets I wanted to out of the flowers that were in the trash can or on the floor.
You know, I was working at a flower shop so I could go to, as a way to go to school, but I loved it. It was just perfect for me. I actually started when Mary was still very active, and I didn't really have any, you know, any training or anything like that, which was great for her because she has a certain way of doing things, and she likes to train each one of her people to do it. And it was kind of very glamorous when I first started at Mary Murray's, because the store had the red carpet out front, and it was, she wanted people to feel like royalty when walking the red carpet. It was really, really glamorous to somebody that grew up in Muskogee, Oklahoma. She just commanded the room. She walked in anywhere and people just stopped and took notice, because it wasn't her beauty necessarily, even though she was a very lovely lady. She just had this presence about her. You know, you've met those people that you're just like, what is it about them? She just walked in and everybody just jumped to attention and, you know, how can I help you and what can I do and that kind of stuff. So she was definitely my hero.
She always loved flowers. She played on her porch as a little girl with flowers and had a pretend flower shop on the front porch of her house. So she always wanted to be a florist and always told me not to do this. It was just too hard. Until she had opened her second shop in Utica Square and needed a little help over there and said, "Galen, would you mind to come and help since you're between jobs? I had just gotten married." I said, "Well, I'm not sure I know enough." She said, "Oh, you know more than you think." And I started in, and sure enough, I knew more than all of the people she'd hired to run the store, so I was back in.
I really thought after working here for almost 30 years that this was going to be just a piece of cake, you know? And obviously when you're working for someone else, you always think that they don't really know anything. And so we jokingly always will say to Galen, which is Mary Murray's daughter, that, well, she didn't really do anything. She was the owner, you know? So when I took over, I know she was just sitting back laughing, because now she gets to see all of the hurdles I'm jumping as owner and who doesn't do anything, you know? But I really thought it would be easier than it was, and maintaining such a high level of excellence you wouldn't think would be that difficult, but it is. It's a lot of work.
You know, Nikki has that same passion that Mary had. She has always enjoyed it from day one, and she has an interest and a head for business. And I think going into the 21st century, that's more and more what a flower shop owner needs to be. It was a delight to get invited to come help part-time with her. It's amazing to me to watch her run this new/old operation, because she's bringing the best of the old and just selecting the best of what the legacy represents and the Mary Murray name represents, and bringing it into this new market that and this new age.
Nobody's going to love the store more than her. You know what I mean? You can't hire enough people that are going to have that same connection. And so I know that having her walk in the door, she's going to take care of everything exactly the way it needs to be done. And besides, we're after 30 years of working together, we're buddies, you know? We made a good team. I just think that sometimes you're lucky enough to fall into something where it's your passion and something you really love. And it's not very often that you get to make that your career.